Okay. So as you know, here what, how you invoke the terminal using Control Alt T. So that if you press here, so your terminal will pop up. This terminal, in this terminal, what I'm going to do here is going to demonstrate today iVerilog open source tool for simulation. So in this, how to install the document, you also can browse from the internet. And for the easy availability, I will share it in the group as well. Since I have already installed here, so I'm just going to demonstrate today full adder example. So let us create first full adder and let us understand how we simulate, and then let us go for the ASIC design tools invocation, and then thereafter how we are performing every step like a floor planning, placement, and how we read the files. That we'll see in the as a first day interaction sort of class. From tomorrow onwards, full-fledged everything we'll understand in the floor planning issues, what are there, and thereafter how we go to the placement and clock tree synthesis and power rails, and then how we go for the routing, and all these issues can be seen, from tomorrow session onwards. Today, just giving you the usage of this tool, how we can play with this tools, a kind of introduction. So let us begin with the CD. What I'm going to do is first make directory. Are you people, I'm assuming majority of the people are aware of this. Are you people, are there anyone who are not aware, if they can speak? Those who are not aware can speak? Not aware. So it seems everyone aware. Okay. So make directory. I made a directory. In this, I'm going to, if you see the LS, you see my here, FA, this pull adder. So in this pull adder, I'm going to use gedit editor. I have to first go to the change directory to pull adder. So I'm there now in this pull adder directory. Nothing is there, LS if I do, there nothing is there. Now I am going to create two files in that. Gedit space pull adder fa.v space fa test bench file. So these two I'm going to create. That's what I have planned. So let us see what is going to happen here. So two files pop-up has come. Okay. So in this, what very quickly I will write, because you people are already familiar with this. I'm just trying to iVerilog introduction I'm giving. Is it seen by everyone what I'm typing?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Anyone having any doubt, they can unmute and ask. Assuming everyone are familiar with this, so that's why without any discussion I'm just proceeding. If you have anyone there, unmute and talk if you have a problem. So this is, hope this discussion is correct. So let us write it as well. Module test. let me copy this information. The typing is right here. Instantiation. Initial. Begin. Here, I'm going to use that dollar dump file, and then semicolon, and here that VCD file name I'm going to give. So value change dump file, VCD extension. So let us give you a create dot VCD and give here dollar dump wraps. Range all I want to write, so because only one module is there and there is no hierarchy that we are going to maintain. This is I less than or equal to 3, and then it's a full adder, right? So then I equal to I plus 1. There are several ways to write, as you know. So begin, and then this one here I'm going to concatenate ABC, and then I put this I, and then delay I'm going to introduce, and then this end, and this end also, and then this the end module also, and then I'm going to have here because this I did not declare, so integer. So Hagan, I guess everything. Yeah.
Hello, sir. Instead of ABC, I have given ABS.
Oh, thank you so much. ABS. Yes. So now, I hope everything is fine. So let us close and minimize these issues. There is something called I vary log, because I have already installed in my system. Those who are not aware, these are the few commands to use a I vary log. It's an open source simulator, lightweight. In Windows also it will work. In a Linux environment also it will work. So I vary log, this is the command to compile the code. So if you see in my current working directory, I have now two files here. So these two files here, if you see, this is a FA test and this FA.v. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to use this I vary log for compilation space. And there is a file, if I compile, if a file will be generated. So that is the O, output file O, and the name I'm going to give FA space. And the files that I want to compile here are fa.v and fa.test.v. So, and then press enter. So now if you ls, if you do, you see the output file being generated here, fa. So if you don't give, then default name something out, I think it will take that compiler. With that, it will generate a file. This hyphen o, this output file name, if you don't give this one where I have pointed, if you don't give this one, then it will generate a out with that name, some file it will be generated. So this is for compilation. So I have compiled now. What I do is now I have to execute that. For execution, this compiled file generated, no, FA, the name I have given, anything name, any name you can choose. So this file I want to execute. So for that, VBP, and then that FA, so, and then press enter. So if you ls now, I mean, if you see into the directory, you see this fa.vcd file is generated. Actually, this we here in our case, fa test dot v. If you see this one here, in this file, I think it's not there here. Command not found. Okay, we are there in that I vary log environment. That's why it is command not found. It is email. So, okay, let us now. What is that? Hold on. executed. Now let us see that GTK wave, and that this file fa.vcd, fa.vcd, and if I click that one, so this GTK waveform editor will come. In this waveform editor, you see here test your module name, test bench module name, and this here your this wires are there. I mean identified A, B, C, your all that. So you can right click, and here you explore here this insert and append. What is the difference? So if I append, then it will prompt really import five facilities, yes or no. This five here, A 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I want yes, I want to see here. I want to import here. So all been imported here. A, B, C, C O some here. So now this one here, zoom fit. If I do zoom fit, then perfect waveform. So I see I can drag this one vertical bar anywhere, and the corresponding where I'm leaving. For example, if I'm leaving here at this point. So now what we see here is the corresponding values are seen here. A is 1, B is 1, C is 1, your sum of carry on. So guys, with this, the advantage what I mean, my opinion is, instead of running after the commercial tools, you have this open source tools for simulation perfectly any design, even in industry, they perform first functional simulation. Without functional simulation, they will not be going to the timing simulation. So static timing analysis or timing simulation or whatever, they will not be performed. First, they ensure that this is met functionally. So, but MTech level or BTech level or even research point of view, you don't really need to run off with the commercial tools. Kindly use this available open source tools. This is the first step of our what we call this simulation tool, iVerilog. So for Windows also available. For what is that called, the other one, Linux environment also available. So let us close this one. That's how you are performing the simulation. Now let us go to what is that called, Qflow environment. Let Qflow, you have this command here, just carefully observe, Qflow space GUI and ampersand. But before typing this, I just want to tell one thing here. LS, if we do what you are seeing here, remember FA test, FA.vcd, only four files. Everyone able to see? Are the people there? Because I am not going to the tab, meet tab. Can someone?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to invoke that Qflow tool. Qflow is actually binding all the tools. Qflow space GUI space ampersand. We can do everything in the command mode also, but this is the graphical user interface. this Qflow manager will come. In this Qflow manager, we have fewer steps here. You see this username here, the project that I mean is the full adder, and the path is here, home root 123 FA is the path here, and I have the technology here. The technology is this is open freely available technology. We can other technology, for example, if you have some other tool technology, some that is not legal actually, illegal is not encouraged. This legal way of doing is whatever available technology files are there, them only you have to use. That is the first point. And legally, if you want to experiment, if your college, if your university, or if your company is permitting you to try the technology file in the open source tool such as this, then with their permission you can incorporate that technology file here with some changes. Those changes and all in subsequent classes will see that. So, but the technology file, you can change them here. Whatever the technology file you want, you can associate with your design. As everyone knows that this just a moment, let me take here. You have with you two files, right? Just a moment, you have two files with you. One is your .v file or .sv file, system.vlog, or .vhd file. This is vhdl, system.vlog, or your vlog, and .lib file. This is foundry provided file. And these two were given with two, yeah, tool synthesizer, and that will be giving you the netlist. And synthesis of two types, actually, basically speaking, generic synthesis and technology synthesis. Technology. For technology synthesis, you need this lib file, library file. For generic synthesis, you don't need this library file. You can perform generic synthesis. So this generic synthesis is not available here in this. It is technology bounded here. Generic, those people who are having experience with Cadence, they might have seen commands are there in that. So synthesis to generic, synthesis to map. So if you type that command in your Genus or RTL compiler, then generic synthesis is possible. Like, for example, what are the gates are there, and what is the interconnectivity among these gates? That information it is going to give. But these gates are not bounded to any specific technology. So this is a generic synthesis. This generic synthesis is not. Here. It's there in the Cadence, but it is not. Synthesis preparation, the first step preparation is these things we have to follow. In the preparation, which technology you are going to work with, and what is the top level source file. Here you have to select the top level source file. So if you have multiple, for example, you are working with the arithmetic logic unit, ALU is your top module. Inside your ALU, you are instantiating your arithmetic module and logical module. Inside arithmetic, there are several other modules that you are maybe instantiating. But ALU is the top. So select the top module and then open. So now this Verilog source file is associated here. And this step and clear stop. If you don't select this set stop, then the moment you click on the run, all the synthesis and replacement, static timing analysis, all will run automatically. So if you set this set stop to click, then if every this step, you know, manually you have to perform. So that is this set stop, if you click this, that is what it is going to do. So once you have set your technology file, once you have set your Verilog top module, and ensure that this Verilog top module name is seen here, so everything is set all right, then set stop you click, then run this preparation. This in progress, and if there are any mistakes, then this will be like failed message will come here. And then if you click on settings here, there is nothing here to set here for the synthesis except this stop flow of the synthesis. You can uncheck this one, if you uncheck, then this flow will run here. If you click, this click actually has come because here we have clicked on the set stop. That's why here you see that this click. Otherwise, if you, at this stage itself, if you did not click this set stop, then directly if you run, everything will run. So let us have the check here. Now we run this synthesis. So the synthesis process, once it is done, once it is done, there are two ways to read this file here. So one way is to click here itself. You see here, if you note carefully, log slash synth.log. With that, here it is everything, every information. It's a log file basically. So synthesis during that, what all will happen, that every report is, you can read here. So the other way around, since you, as I was telling you, to remember your two things here. If you type here LS now, you see the several things here. Earlier, before launching this one, I said only few things are there. But if you see this project underscore wrap.sh and qflow.sh, these are the script files generated by the qflow manager. And synthesis, source, log, these are generated by the layout, source, synthesis. These are generated by the Qflow manager. Actually, according to the instruction of this Qflow, we as a user have to create first layout, source, synthesis, three files, and then we have to keep in the source directory all source files. Unlike here, I kept here outside of this, so I have to keep inside the source. That is what the tool instructions are there. Let us see what is there in the source here. Because I did not keep, the tool has created. So these are the files inside, you see. This is a dot lib. This is during synthesis, these files file format being generated. And this is a script file for your, you know, the point here is this point I'm trying to make here. This everything is being generated except this fa.pcd, this and fa test. These are the part of earlier I will log. Other than that, layout, this shell files and this folder and this other shell, all being generated by the Qflow. So for proper organization, it has been instructed to create manually, make directory, source, synthesis, layout, these files. And coming to the log file here, if you see the log file, a log folder. So inside log folder, you will see that report here. Instead seeing from here, we were seeing from this one here. This entire one here. This is seen very much, it is seen from here itself. I don't know whether this is going to work or not. How to explore, how to interact with the tool, that is the session today. So that's why I'm just letting you know all this interfacing. What is that file? Synth. Okay. Log. So if you see that it has this one, that one, the same. So this is one way of, the other way of having, I mean, look at this file. So the other one, this is another way of interacting. Now here, before going to the placement, those people who are aware of chip, this is your chip is, shape and this shape or this shape is decided by anyone can I mean, I just want to see what decides the shape of the ship. I just want to see whether people are aware, because yes, somebody, I think.
Sir, width of transistor.
No, chip, shape of the chip. Shape. shape of your SIM card is there, your SIM card. Earlier it was something like that shape, wherein the part of this is your logic, your SIM card. And some wires were coming out like that four. And this we use it to put inside our phone, the SIM. And these four wires would be getting connected inside the phone, something, this will sit on that and our phone will start working, connecting to the network. And inside this is the shape, here shape is this shape. But later SIMs have come, small, tiny, nano, micro, nano, something. And in some here, if you go here, where, just a moment. Which one is my number? So your Arduino. Arduino. 28. Now, if you see here, this one, you see here, this one, the chip shape here. Everybody able to see the chip shape?
Yes, sir.
Now the other chip shape here, you see the chip shape here, this one?
Yes, sir.
What is the difference between this shape and this chip shape?
Square and rectangle.
This is in a square shape and this is a rectangular shape. Is it not? Is it not?
Sir.
Yeah. So now the question is, what decides this the shape of the chip? What is that? What is the factor that is deciding? Is the question?
So pins.
No.
Accept ratio and utilization factor.
Utilization factor will not decide, only aspect ratio will decide.
Yeah, right. Okay.
So, can you help me, what is aspect ratio?
Accept ratio is nothing but height and width of the chip, entire chip.
Height, the ratio of L by W, you mean?
Height by width.
Height, length, that is length. Height,
yeah,
length
and width, right.
But if you see some of the books, majority of the books, they said W by L.
Yes, sir, W by L.
So now let us see how it is impacting. Let us say first we have this shape. This is a sort of equal here. This is let us say this is 2 and this is also 2. Somebody please mute. This is 2. Now, let us say this is our W and let us say this is our L. Now, I am increasing this one, this width. So, this will become like this. This width I have increased. And this I have decreased. The shape has become like this. Now, if I am increasing the height and decreasing the width, so this is my width, this is my L. I have increased my L and I have decreased my width. So the shape has become like this. So from all this, what is the conclusion is, this from this window, from this here, this board manufacturer, this architecture level, top level, people will say that I want this sort of this shape of rectangular I see here, because they have some idea in their mind, and I want the other around, other shape here. So like that, the conclusion is drawn at the top level. If you see, there are different ICs, different types will be there. You see, so there are several pictures like that. So IC shapes are actually decided by that aspect ratio. So as aspect ratio. Now what is happens with the, not only shape of the IC is affected, and also let us say I have some shape like this. Now I have my macros placed with here. My macros placed with here. My routing places are now, this is my routing, and this, these are my routing places. For routing, available space is that. Now if I make my shape like this, these components I cannot accommodate. I can accommodate them macros here. Here. So my this one here, routing would be like this one. So vertical, these are the vertical. Earlier vertical only one. Now I can have two more. Meaning if you make shape of this sort of vertical routing, more possible vertical routings. If you make this sort of shape, then I can place them like this. Then possibly no vertical, everything is a horizontal routing. More horizontal routings. So depending upon the shape, this routing factor, routing sources also will decide the shape of the chip. Now, apart from this W by L, the ratio of this W by L, that is aspect ratio, which is deciding the shape of the chip, what more is affecting the shape of the chip is the routing sources. The more routing is required, that also will dictate the shape of the chip. That is the point I am trying to make. So that one here, if you go here in our displacement here, before running this, we have aspect ratio. If you change, you play with this today, those who said we have installed the software, you change this and see the shape of the chip while it is running. So the point here, what I am trying to make here is, this one, where is this one here, depending upon your aspect ratio shape, what one is aspect ratio is dictating what shape you need. The other factor that dictates is what routing sources you have and in which fashion they need to be connected. This for example, the taken board here, if inside this is actually connecting to many IOs here. This is actually interfacing with here this section and this section and also this section and also the other sections, because this is, after all, this is the main. These are the auxiliary ICs, maybe power supporting for that these ICs. But the main functioning IC is this. These IC pins, if you see here, there are more pins. If you see the pins here, this point here, if you see here, the whether you people are understanding here, this side, the pins if you see, and this pins if you see, if I tilt this one, the board, the other side, then everywhere it is connected. So how much routing is inside required here? So that factor also will dictate the shape of this IC. So the point why I am making here is, one thing is aspect ratio is actually not decided by us, decided by the application, and architecture level engineers will tell us you have to maintain this aspect ratio. That is one factor as a physical design engineers we have to understand. And also the routing sources, how many are there, that also we have to understand. Now arrange pins, if you go here, if you see the pins now, you have the chip area, this one here, but the pins are placed here. So whether these pins have to keep left side or top side or bottom side or right hand side, again this will dictate here. This will dictate here. If you see here the pins connected here, left hand side and the bottom side and the right hand side and the upper top side, they are actually decided by the people who are manufacturing this board architecture level. They say that this side top will come IO pins here. You can plug in IO pins. So because they should be nearby to this, so these pins should come top. And these pins will interact with some other auxiliary ICs, they should come left. So such information is not decided by the PD, physical design engineer. They come from the higher authority, the other team. Accordingly, we have to decide here the pins placement. So for placing the pins here in this tool, what we have to do is we have to create a new group. In this new group, we have to give my left pins. Suppose say my left pins and then click OK. So now my right pins, click OK. So this, if you see my left pins and my right pins, there are no pins actually here now. So this I have to select and I have to drag them here. For selecting, what you have to do is you have to right click, because A, B, C, I want them to be as my left pins. So right click once, the shape will, bit color will, background color will be seen like white, something, some color. So right click again this one, and this also you right click. So all three being selected now. So now you hold your left mouse button, drag them here and drop where you want, under my right pins or my left pins. So just drop them. Like that they have come. Now these pins here, again right click and right click, so that both can be selected at once, and drag them with your left mouse button here, my right pins. Now you fix them here by selecting them left mouse button, and I want to keep them to the left here. So this is unchecked, and this is unchecked, this is unchecked, and left, and permute will be selected like that. And default will leave the values. And the my right here, just remove this, let this be right, remove this bottom and remove this left, and fix it. And this unsigned you can leave like that, or if you don't want to see that unsigned here, you can go here, you can delete that group unsigned here. Then you will see only two, my left pins and my right pins. If you are leaving like that, also no issues with that. Now click on apply. So now you have done your pin arrangement. So placement graphic view. If you want to see this running while running a graphic view, you have to check this one, or else you can uncheck this one. So now you have several things to explore here. We'll see in subsequent classes. Strip width, strip pitch. In between here, we run the power rails. When we run the power rails here, your macro is this. So this macro is this. So if you are running with the power rails here, side by, if you're running, what is the distance that you want to keep between the metal to metal? Which metal type actually these are? What is the width that you want to keep of this metal? That depends upon how much power it is actually, holding it, this, capable of holding this metal itself. So all those things you will be covered in subsequent classes. But depending upon that, your strip width, strip pitch, all that you decide. But for now, we are keeping everything like that. You can explore from home. Just today, as I said, we are I'm giving how you interface actually to the tool. So having set all this arrangements done, and this aspect ratio, as I said, you can play. If you are keeping one, then as I said here, with my rectangular square shape, if W by L is greater than one, then the aspect ratio is greater than one, meaning it's a rectangular, and otherwise it's a vertical rectangle. if you is w by n is less than. So that, having said all this, now you run this. So this shape you see here, shape you note in your mind here. This is the shape that you have seen. So if you go here and if you set this one 0.5, this one here 0.5, and run again. This is done already. We have done this. Run again. This shape. Are you noticing some change or no? Are you people there?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. So that's the placement, and in which way it is affecting and all, we'll see in subsequent classes. So now, if you see this file here, we have dev files, left files, everything we will see in subsequent classes. So after placement, this is the you see here log slash p place dot log, this file, log file this is. If any errors are there, everything, all details you kindly explore today. So as much possible you kindly explore what input files it has taken. So that one, again the same story, you can go to your terminal here, you can see that less log, because in less ls log, in that a new folder has come, new file, that is the place.log after synthesis. Earlier only preparation file and synthesis file were there, now place.log file. So this file in the terminal itself also you can see, because what is the difference then seeing from here or from there is, you can search anything if you want to search here in this terminal. If you go through the tool here, that is here, you cannot search here anything that you want to search for example. You have to scroll and to see where that value is. So that way, this is the interface. Now coming to this static timing analysis, we'll talk about this tomorrow. Till this portion, you can kindly you can explore this also from home, because the reason why I'm stopping here is continuously I'm running from 7 o'clock, so a bit I just want to stop. 7 to 8 very large class, now this class. So guys, is that clear how we are interfacing, how we are launching this tool? Let me run.
Yes, sir.
Let me run very quickly every portion, because I just want to show you here where is that, how you launch this layout. Because if you launch the layout now, because you see the launch edit, edit layout, what is that you see? Let us explore. Since routing is not done, possibly your magic layout tool will not pop up. Because we have to do this LVS and then GDS, and thereafter this is possible, because magic is another tool. We'll see in subsequent classes every tool introduction, what it does, how we use, and we also see the theory of floor planning, placement, and static timing analysis and routing issues. So with this said, today I conclude this session. Let me run this very quickly, because just I want to show you that that portion here. Once this is done, and this delays also we can study. Static timing analysis after post route, this there will be difference between these two. This is a pre layout, after layout this one here. So this delays, again you can read going through this way, what is the delay. This is your path delay, you see here input pin D2, output pin sum delay is 150.993 picoseconds. So see, in similar way, what is that before floor planning, that delay, where that delay you kindly note. So what is the difference, you will understand why that delay has come, what is the cell characterization, who has gathered this delay and all that, we have to study. So ignore this. Now run this. So this is your magic layout room. This, I just go here. Zoom to quick gear from where is the zoom on zoom. Full view. So this is your complete full adder layout. So if I type in this box is being selected. And if I go here, this is the command window. If I type here box, and you see the microns here, this microns here, 4429.57, that's the area of this micron in micron. The chip that is this chip is consuming, what is the area it is consuming? 429.57 units are, this area units are in microns. So a lot more to explore here, how we actually even this even we can have a complete layout design, that is what is that you call it as full custom design using magic alone. So lot more things to explore. So guys, I think now you bit exposure has come, how you can play with the truth, whether it has come or wasted definitely joining this session.
It helps, sir.
Useful.
Okay, I request kindly today those who did not install, kindly install and explore. iVerilog also you kindly install for simulation, open source tool it is. And this complete flow, this tool, what we have seen, this QFlow manager is the interfacing environment for running the synthesis tool, placement tool, static timing analysis, all those tools what we have installed here from this, where it is, here I said here, let me zoom this bit. YOSIS for RTL synthesis. How the synthesis happened? Because of YOSIS tool. This is a tool. So this is high fan out net synthesis, that blip fan out tool. This is another tool. So gray wool for placement. This is another tool which has helped us to for placement, floor planning and placement. And the Q router. This is another tool which has helped us to have this complete this routing here, this routing in between the components, how this been routed, every layout that took place in between the connections, the how the connections are connections took place. So for that this is the router for carrying out. After routing, magic has helped us to open the layout. And NetGen is a tool for performing this. If you see this one here, this tool, layout versus schematic. So you may ask where is the schematic. You explore tomorrow, we'll answer for that. Meanwhile, you kindly explore. So this, if you see circuit one here, the circuit one and the circuit two. So this is what layout versus schematic.